Noisy generators. Have you ever been camping and the peaceful serenity was ruined by a noisy generator? Was it your own generator? I'll show you how we made this inexpensive noise reduction box or sound box to make our generator quieter. But first, let's do some sound testing to compare noise levels with and without the box. And then I'm going to show you how we made it. Today's video, we're going to show you this nice sound box that we made. And it has a cooling fan on it, and it has a carpet in there to deaden the sound of our generator. In another video, I showed the generator without the sound box. We did a review of the generator, and we did sound decibel testing next to it, and we did it at 25 feet. So if you like this video, make sure you subscribe below and give us a thumbs up, and we'll do some reviews of the sound. And let's go ahead and get started. Push the generator into the sound box. All right, so let's get this thing turned on. All right, so standing next to it, let's get a sound reading off of my microphone. So without the box, we were at 64.9. And now, standing next to the box, we're at 59. So at 25 feet, we're at about 50 decibels. And before, we were at 53. So that's a lot quieter with the box. So now let's do it with the full load. All right, standing next to it now, we're at 65 decibels, whereas before we were at 73. So that's a huge difference. Now we're gonna go out to 25 feet. Now keep in mind, it's a full load now. We've got the oven on in the camper. So let's go out to 25. Out here at 25 feet with a full load on the generator, we're at about 63 decibels with the box on it. So I think that's a huge difference. All right, that finishes up the sound testing. Now I'm gonna go ahead and show you how this thing is all folded up and how compact it is. So this is the front of the sound box. We have a 200 CFM AC fan that we plug right into the front of the generator when it's running. This helps move air through the sound box. And let's take a look inside the sound box. It's got carpet lining in there, and then we have the dryer vent in the front, and that's where the exhaust vents through. There's a reason why we didn't put carpet on the top, and I'll show you in a second. When we fold it up, it won't allow it to fold up properly. This is the back of the unit with the dryer vent. We have these holes cut out just to help some heat escape. And with the fan blowing from the front, it really helps them move the air through. Also, we have the cutouts down below, and that allows some air to move through as well. And then we generally carry this rug with us because when we're camping with a concrete pad, sound reverberates off the concrete. So we generally put the generator on this, then we put the box over top of it. This particular generator, it pulls air from the bottom. So it also helps to pull air up through. All right, I'm gonna take this thing apart and I'm gonna show you all the measurements. All right, so the measurements on the back end, we made them the width of a 2x4. So we have the 2x4 in there for the spacer, and so it's 3.5. And then these holes we cut out, they're about 13x5. And they're the same in the front, so 13x5. Then we covered it with the carpet. And I'll show you the reason why we notched this out. All right, so this is the notch. It's because of the board that's right there. So when we put it together, it goes in there just like that. So the notch is there. And boy, you can really hear the difference with my voice with the carpet. So the reinforcement on the corners serves two purposes. This is aluminum angle iron. And when I made this, it's also part of the keeper system. So I allowed for the 1/2-inch plywood. There's a gap there, and that helps to lock it all together. And then we have these 1/4-inch detent pins that go in. And that's what holds it all together. It's 4 pins on 4 corners. Our overall inside height is 21 3/4. So it's 21 3/4 inches tall on the inside. And And then the overall width is 2 foot. So it's a 2 foot box. It's 2 foot wide. So of course you have the half inch channels to receive the sides. So the measurements for this backside is the same as the front. Now let me show you the three-piece construction of the body. All right, so we engineered this so that when it folds together, this is raised up enough so that it closes on top. Our overall height on this is 21 and a quarter. That way, when we're done, it's the outside measurement is 22 and a quarter, and it's the same on this side. It's that 22 and a quarter. So this piece is actually cut 21 and three quarters so that it closes inside of there. And then again, this piece is 21 and a quarter. The length is 35 and three quarters. So when you cut these, you want to cut them 35 and three quarters, all three pieces. And then the top piece is exactly 2 foot. These are just four hinges that I picked up at either Home Depot or Lowe's, I can't remember. These are just basic utility hinges. And then of course, the measurements on our holes is about 19 and a half. And I think we made them 2 inches tall. This is how compact it is. It folds down to this, folds down to about 2 inches. This is generally how we travel with it. We usually put it like this, and then I have straps that go around it. It folds up to this with the straps that we made. It's pretty easy to carry, and it's easy to pack up. Here's what we learned out in the desert. Sound travels with the wind, it bounces around, and depending on where you're sitting, it affects how you hear it. Our noise reduction box reduce sound levels between 5 and 8 decibels at 25 feet. That took the noise level down to 63 decibels. Normal conversation occurs between 60 and 70 decibels. We came in at the lower end of that. At idle, it was 51 decibels. A normal refrigerator is at 55. All these numbers might seem incremental, but 5 to 8 decibels in a quiet campground can make a difference. I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm glad you watched, and I hope you'll watch again.